Surveying is the science of determining the terrestrial or three-dimensional positions of points and the distances and angles between them. These points are usually on the surface, but in mines, they may be under the surface of the earth. They are often used to establish maps and boundaries for ownership, locations, the surface location of a subsurface feature, etc. Surveyors work with elements of geometry, trigonometry, regression analysis, physics, engineering, metrology, programming languages, and the law. They use equipment such as theodolites, total stations, GPS receivers, 3D scanners, surveying software, and many other things. At SCCL, the surveyors are responsible for preparing and updating the entire surface and underground plans of a mine. They plan the direction and extent of all underground mine workings and use advanced surveying techniques and instruments to give these directions underground. Mine surveys undertake both underground and surface surveys designed to produce information for the construction of mine plans. They have to ensure that accurate and up-to-date plans of the mine are prepared in accordance with survey and drafting directions and prepare mine working plans of the mine. In underground mines, surveyors measure mine workings in full detail. Their measurements enable new mine works to avoid older and non-productive ones and allow connections to be made between different underground passages. Mine surveyors also establish the boundaries of mining claims. For instance, surveyors work underground, giving direction lines for the miners to follow. They help draw the center lines on the roof of underground mines. These lines are used for roof bolting to keep the working area safe during the operations. They are responsible for maintaining an accurate plan of the mine as a whole and will update the maps of the surface layout to account for new buildings and other structures, as well as surveying the underground mine workings in order to keep a record of the mining operation. This allows the mining engineers to decide which blocks are economical to extract and which are not. As a result of this information, a plan for the extraction of blended mixture of low and high grade coal can be made. This planning ensures that the mining process is prolonged, the removal of coal is optimized, and SCCL is able to operate at consistently high levels of efficiency. This aspect of the work has turned the surveying department into a major resource of SCCL. But how do they perform these tasks with such accuracy? The main work of mine surveyors in underground mines is carried out hundreds of meters below the surface. Reduced level in surveying refers to equating elevations of survey points with reference to a common assumed datum. It is a vertical distance between survey point and adapted datum plane. Auto levels instruments are used in underground mines of SCCL. They consist of a telescope with an optical measuring system. The focus knob is turned to obtain a sharp image of the staff. Based on the readings, the reduced level of a given point is determined. These compact and light instruments are being used at SCCL for leveling to determine benchmarks for surface and underground mines, and also for leveling for subsidence survey in mining areas.
ఈ లెవెలింగ్ ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్ తోటి ఇది పిల్లర్స్ యొక్క ఇక్కడ పాయింట్లలో ఏవైతే ఉన్నాయో ఆ పాయింట్ల యొక్క ఆర్ల్స్ కనుక్కోవడానికి అని చెప్పి మేము ఈ ఆటో లెవెల్ తోటి లెవెలింగ్ చేస్తున్నాం. ఈ ఆటో లెవెల్ తోటి లెవెలింగ్ ఎట్లా అంటే దీని యొక్క బేస్ పాయింట్ మాకు సర్ఫేస్లో బెంచ్ మార్క్ ఉంటుంది ఒకటి. ఆ బెంచ్ మార్క్ నుంచి మేము లెవెలింగ్ చేసుకుంటూ ఇక్కడ ఎక్కడైతే వర్కింగ్ స్టేషన్స్ ఉన్నాయో వర్కింగ్ స్టేషన్ దగ్గర పాయింట్ల ద్వారా తెచ్చుకుంటాం. బెంచ్ మార్క్ ఎక్కడి నుంచి వస్తుందంటే మనం మీన్సి లెవెల్ దగ్గర నుంచి మనం బెంచ్ మార్క్ మీన్సి లెవెల్ తోటి కనెక్ట్ అయి ఉంటుంది. దాని ద్వారా మనం ఆ బెంచ్ మార్క్ని మనం ఇక్కడ ఒకటి ఎస్టాబ్లిష్ చేసుకుంటాము. ఎస్టాబ్లిష్ చేసుకున్న బెంచ్ మార్క్ ద్వారా మనం అండర్గ్రౌండ్కి మనం పాయింట్లని లెవెల్ దీని ద్వారా మనం అండర్గ్రౌండ్లో లెవెలింగ్ చేసుకుంటూ మనకి ఎక్కడెక్కడైతే మనకి జంక్షన్స్ ఉంటాయో ఆ జంక్షన్స్ ఆఫ్ పిల్లర్ల గురించి మనం పాయింట్లు ప్రిపేర్ చేసుకుంటూ ఉంటాము. అది తర్వాత మనం సర్ఫేస్లో కూడా కాంటోర్ లైన్స్ ఒకటి ఉంటాయి మనకి. ఆ కాంటోర్ లైన్స్ ఏంటంటే ఇప్పుడు అక్కడ ఉన్న ఒక కాంటోర్ లైన్కి ఒక పర్టికులర్ ఫిగర్ సపోజ్ ఒక 850 ఉందనుకోండి అక్కడ సర్ఫేస్లో ఆర్ఎల్, మనకి అండర్గ్రౌండ్లో ఆర్ఎల్ ఇంకా తక్కువ ఉంటుంది. ఆ తక్కువ ఉండడం వల్ల ఏంటంటే మనం పైనుంచి సర్ఫేస్ దగ్గర నుంచి మనం అండర్ గ్రౌండ్ లో ఎంత డెప్త్ లో ఉన్నామో అన్న విషయం మనకి ఈ లెవెలింగ్ చేసుకోవడం ద్వారా మనకి తెలుస్తుంది.
సో యాజ్ పర్ కోల్ మైన్స్ రెగ్యులేషన్ 2017 the pillar size is already restricted as per the depth and width of the gallery. So by knowing the reduced level of this point, we can determine the pillar size for the pillar size. Not only that, by knowing the reduced level of all the points, we can determine the gradient. We can know the full deep gradient of the seam, and also so many safety measures, this reduced levels are required to project the method of work. Okay, so how will develop or how will reduce the pillars or how will extract the panels, it is depending upon the depth of the working. That's why to know the depth of the working, we have to carry out leveling from surface, and we have to establish calculate the reduced level of all the junctions. This is the purpose. That's why we are doing leveling here.
Total stations are being used for more precise calculations in both underground and open cast mines of SCCL. A total station is a combination of an electronic distance measurement, electronic theodolite, and a programmed calculator. With these instruments, the inclined distance and horizontal and vertical angles to target are measured automatically at the push of a button. The angle measurement system of the total station is similar to that of an electronic theodolite. The dynamic angle measuring system used in the total station makes use of a large number of graduation for each reading of the angle on horizontal or vertical circle of the instrument. This helps eliminate as far as possible the effects of graduation errors. The other parameters like horizontal distance, coordinates, levels, etc. are also calculated automatically and displayed digitally.
Theodolite తోనే మనము angles మాత్రమే measure చేస్తాము, distance measure చేయడానికి ఉండదు. అందులో only angle measure చేసి టేప్ తోని స్టీల్ టేప్ తోని మనం రీడింగ్స్ మళ్ళీ డిస్టెన్స్ ని క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేసి దాన్ని బట్టి కోఆర్డినేట్ క్యాలిక్యులేషన్ చేసి ఆ తర్వాత ప్లాట్ చేస్తాము. అక్కడ మాన్యువల్ ఎర్రర్స్ అనేవి చాలా ఎక్కువగా ఉండే అవకాశం ఉంది. సో థియోడలైట్స్ అనేవి అందుకోసమనే సింగరేని అనేది కొంచెం పక్కకు పెట్టాల్సి వచ్చింది. అట్లా డైలీ మానిటరింగ్ చేసేయడానికి ఈ టోటల్ స్టేషన్ అనేది చాలా ఉపయోగపడుతుంది. ఓకేనా? తర్వాత ఎవ్రీ ర్యాంప్స్ కానీ, ర్యాంప్ గ్రేడియంట్స్ కానీ, తర్వాత మనకు వచ్చే బెంచెస్ కానీ, అట్లా బెంచ్ కట్టింగ్స్ కానీ, ఇవన్నీ చాలా ఈజీగా అవుతున్నాయి టోటల్ స్టేషన్తో. ఇదే యాంగిల్ ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్తో మనం ఇంత యాక్యురేట్గా చేయలేము, ఇంత యాక్యురేట్గా పాయింట్స్ ఇవ్వలేము.
3D laser scanning is now being implemented in the open cast mines of SCCL. This is a state-of-the-art surveying method. 3D laser imaging system provides a user with a dense set of three-dimensional vectors to unknown points relative to the scanner's location. Given the volume of points and high sampling frequency, laser imaging systems offer surveyors an unprecedented density of geospatial information coverage. Two factors are common in all mining operations, which makes laser mapping a rapid and cost-effective technology for SCCL. Firstly, mining involves moving volumes of material from one place to another, and the only way to know what is really going on is to measure the excavated volume of that material. Using conventional surveying technology, mine surveyors used to spend a great deal of time surveying spot heights in order to calculate volumes. Secondly, most mines have areas that are difficult to access and therefore difficult to survey. Laser mapping allows to undertake high accuracy surveys from a safe distance. It gives more details, which opens up the possibilities for using the data in more detailed design work or in geotechnical assessments.
దీని రేంజ్ వచ్చేసి 4 కిలోమీటర్స్. మనకి ఏంటంటే 4 కిలోమీటర్స్ మీన్స్ హైలీ రిఫ్లెక్టివ్ సర్ఫేసెస్, లో రిఫ్లెక్టివ్ అనమాట. ఇది మనకు 2 కిలోమీటర్స్ వరకు ఎఫెక్టివ్గా వస్తుంది. నెక్స్ట్ ఇది ఎక్విప్డ్ విత్ 36 మెగాపిక్సెల్ కెమెరా. మొత్తం వారి అంతా ఒక పొజిషన్ నుండి స్కాన్ చేయడానికి 14 minutes పడుతుంది ఇక్కడ ఈ పొజిషన్. నెక్స్ట్ మనకు ఏంటంటే ఈ మొత్తం క్వారీ అంతా చేయడానికి ఒక 4-5 scans మనం దాంట్లో అయిపోద్ది. మొత్తం టోటల్ 1 డేలో మనకు స్కాన్ చేసి మన డేటా దీని ద్వారా ఏంటంటే ల్యాప్టాప్కు వచ్చేస్తుంది డేటా. అక్కడ నుంచి ప్రాసెసింగ్ రిస్క్ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ ఉంటుంది దానికి సంబంధించింది దాంట్లో చేస్తాం. దాంట్లో ఉన్న ఈ మిషనరీ అంతా ఎడిటింగ్ అంతా చేసుకొని మనం వాల్యూమ్ క్యాలిక్యులేషన్ చేసి ఇచ్చేస్తాం.
With the 3D laser scanning systems in place at SCCL, we can now accurately map, model and interpret geological structures in a pit, digitize boundaries, structures and features of interest directly in a 3D spatially correct environment, export 3D CAD drawings combined with other geological information in external databases. Conducting end-of-month survey has become very easy with detailed and accurate models available to the survey department. Using this, our surveyors are able to accurately calculate dips and strikes, truck and shovel load measurements, and analyze haul roads, volume measurements, conduct rapid pre- and post-blast surveys, etc. The scanners that are used by SCCL have an accuracy of about 6 millimeters within the prescribed range. The volume of the dumps of overburden removed from the surface of the mining property will also be surveyed. Each month, the survey department measures the quantity of the work done by the mining contractors and calculate their contract earnings. Their work has to be very accurate at all the times.
The survey department, role of survey department right from the beginning of the mine opening and at the time of closure also, survey department is the main role to complete the unit. Overview of all activities of the connected departments, maintenance of entire company's plan, BD works, business development works, framing guidelines for survey works, entire offloading check survey works, vetting of lead for operated OC queries, final scrutiny of offloading proposals, requirement and placement of surveys in units and departments, framing of required training scheme. These are the works we are operating at Singareni level from unit to corporate office.
Differential Global Positioning Systems, DGPS, is an enhancement to the global positioning system, which can provide improved location accuracy in the range of up to 10 centimeters in case of the best implementations. Now, DGPS is being used by surveyors of SCCL. Each DGPS uses a network of fixed ground-based reference stations to broadcast the difference between the positions indicated by the GPS satellite system and known fixed positions. It achieves higher positional accuracy by making use of the differential capabilities of two GPS antenna linked by a radio signal. This system is allowing our survey teams to achieve very accurate measurements.
ఇది బేస్ అంటారు. ఈ బేసు శాటిలైట్ నుంచి వచ్చే సిగ్నల్స్ ఇండిపెండెంట్ తీసుకొని ఇందులో కంట్రోలర్లో మా కార్నర్స్ ఫీడ్ చేస్తాం రియల్ టైంలో. ఇది 12 వాట్స్ బ్యాటరీ. ఈ బ్యాటరీ నుంచి శాటిల్ పవర్ తీసుకొని దీని ద్వారా అక్కడ యాంటీనాకి ఇస్తే ఈ రిలేషన్తో మా మిగతా రోవర్స్ అన్నీ పనిచేస్తాయి. అది రియల్ టైం సర్వే, స్టాటిక్ సర్వే. ఏ రోవర్కి ఆ రోవరు డిపెండెంట్ ఇండిపెండెంట్ అది అన్ని శాటిలైట్ నుంచి వచ్చే డైరెక్ట్ కోఆర్డినేట్సే వస్తాయి. దానికి సంబంధం ఉండదు. స్టాటిక్ సర్వే ఓన్లీ లాటిట్యూడ్ లాంగిట్యూడే వస్తుంది స్టాటిక్ సర్వే. రియల్ టైమ్ సర్వే యుఎన్జీ నేషనల్ గ్రిడ్ యూటీఎం WS-84 మూడు ఏ కోఆర్డినేట్ ఉన్నా మేము చేసుకుంటాం. దీంతో ఓపెన్ ఏరియాలో 10 కిలోమీటర్స్ నియర్ మ్యాక్సిమం 10 కిలోమీటర్స్ రేడియస్ వరకు మనం సర్వే చేసుకోవచ్చు. ఒక బేస్ ఇక్కడ పెట్టి మేము రోవర్లు పట్టుకుని 10 కిలోమీటర్స్ వరకు వెళ్ళిపోవచ్చు. 5 to 10 కిలోమీటర్స్ రేంజ్ వరకు మేము ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్ షిఫ్టింగ్ అంటే ఏమి లేకుండా రోవర్లు పట్టుకొని డైరెక్ట్ వర్క్ చేస్తాం. దానివల్ల వర్క్ ఎక్కువ అవుతుంది, మాకు వర్క్ కూడా యాక్యురసీ ఎక్కువ ఉంటుంది.
దిస్ ఇస్ అన్ అడ్వాన్స్డ్ ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్ డెవలప్మెంట్ ఓవర్ హ్యాండ్ హెల్డ్ జీపీఎస్. దిస్ హ్యాండ్ హెల్డ్ జీపీఎస్ ఇస్ అన్ ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్ విచ్ గివ్స్ ద గ్లోబల్ కోఆర్డినేట్స్ ఇన్ జియోడిటిక్ ఫార్మ్ ఆర్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఫార్మాట్ దట్ హ్యాస్ with a handheld GPS up to an accuracy of around 5 to 10 meters. This differential GPS instrument, which now they have been developed and put into use, is another instrument which gives an accuracy of plus or minus 1 or 2 mm accuracy. For this, inter-visibility is not required. These instruments are placed at a known point where the coordinates are of a particular point is known, and an unknown location where it is very far off, even some kilometers, those coordinates and those values can be arrived at. The surveying with the drone, that is also playing a vital role in surveying, which is reducing huge amount of time and manpower and whatnot, everything. So that is being introduced. It is in a very premature stage in Singareni, which we want to introduce, and we are introducing it. We have certain test trials taken over, and the accuracy part we have to look into it, and if at all it works, it becomes a fantastic achievement. Singareni is outstanding in the field of surveying, where it has gained a good reputation, name, fame, with the help of the management for providing the facilities and exposing us to such kind of a new generation surveying instruments and techniques.
The coming of global positioning systems, total stations and 3D laser scanners has made the acquisition of data much simpler and faster at SCCL than before, and this has turned the survey team of SCCL into one of the best in India. Meanwhile, the Estates Department takes care of acquisition of forest, private and government lands for mining based on the details given by project planning and survey departments. They obtain mining leases for coal and sand, and also they renew them. Protection of companies' landed property, detection and eviction of encroachments on companies' lands, administration of companies' establishments, and attending to court cases arising out of estate matters, and coordination of inspections of officials from revenue, forest, Ministry of Environment and Forestry and Mines, and payment of taxes related to quarters and buildings to the local bodies, etc., are taken care by the Estates Department.
So unlike other industries, not only manpower, machinery, capital, Singareni needs large extent of lands for its mines. Estate Department takes care of acquisition of private lands, alienation of government land, diversion of forest lands for its mining operations. Singareni is planning to produce to cross 100 million tons in the next 5 coming years. Hence, Singareni needs much more land for its future mining operations. There is an old land, LAA 1894, and it has been enacted with the new one, LARR Act 2013. Rehabilitation and resettlement has become integral part of the new act, whereas it was not there, and some certain governments, state governments have given GOs, and Singareni used to fall GO MS 68 to implement R&R. The new act, definitely it is benefiting the land losers, those who are losing land, and it is as in the title, it is very transparent act. Singareni is sending us for different trainings to have more knowledge about the act, and in the process, I think all the estates officer of Singareni, they are having definitely great understanding about the new act. In addition to this, Estate Department is also taking up mining leases. Mining lease is a statute to have to open a mine. We apply, we take mining lease through DMG. DMG forward it to state government to Ministry of Coal. Ministry of Coal gives a prior permission. Now it's called as reservation. And after this, mining plans are prepared, ECs are made, forest clearance is also obtained, diversion. And after all these things, mining plan, EC and forest land diversion,
mining lease is executed between Singareni and Mines and Geology Department. And we have also diversion of forest diversion. We apply to PCCF. PCCF will authenticate the extent of forest. And there is a new act, ROFR 2006, that is the rights over the forest, reservation of forest rights. Those who are cultivating in the forest lands, they also, there is an act wherein they got every right, like they are the patta holders of as like private land. So forest land diversions, we apply, and after this, and for every diversion of forest land, we should do afforestation, that is called compensatory afforestation. Now they have been liberalized in compensatory afforestation because lands are not available. Forest are liberalized by identifying double the degraded. Suppose 100 hectares of forest land is being diverted, we need to do 200 hectares of degraded forest land. Of course, it depends upon the density of the forest. It should be less than 0.4 density. Such lands are identified and we take up afforestation. In fact, we don't take up, we pay for it. And forest department take up the afforestation. Later, all the applications goes to Ministry of Environment Forest. There, FAC meetings conduct, stage 1 clearances will be given, stage 1 some stipulations will be made, compliance report has to be made, and NPV has to be paid, and after that stage 2 clearance will be obtained. This is the forest land process.
They also take care of implementation of the National Rehabilitation and Resettlement Policy with an objective to assist project displaced and project affected people in the surrounding areas of our operations.
In addition to the acquisition of land, sometimes some of the habitats has to be displaced. So for displaced, we need to rehabilitate them. In addition to the compensation we pay, we prepare rehabilitation sites, we do all developments of the site, give plots, that is around 240 square yards of each PDF we give. PDF is known as who has crossed 18 years and displaced from that place is called PDF, and every such PDF is being allotted with a plot in addition to the R&R package, and also in addition to the structure of his house as well as the land value of his site.
This ensures in continuous operations along with prosperous and thriving communities around our mining operations, with sustainable growth in society and economic activities in the region.